Hey, what's up? This one is going to be a little different. I'm going to tell you about how I started and what I did to learn After Effects. So first of all, for those of you who don't know me, my name is Jacek Adamczyk and it's pronounced like this. Yeah, I know, it's weird, I'm Polish. So I use After Effects to make my videos stand out from the crowd. So how long was I learning until I felt comfortable in the program? How much I've spent on courses, and how did my first video look? Or VFX video, I'll show you both. So my journey with After Effects began as probably it did for many of you. I played around with video editing programs. First it was Premiere, then I tried Final Cut Pro X for a while, then I got back to Premiere. I was creating some commercial projects for clients, but I wanted to be able to do something different, something that would allow my work to stand out, and with that, I could provide more value to my clients. Because obviously what you're trying to do in social media is to get attention for the video and help to sell the product. And even before editing videos, I did some photography as a hobby. And I was playing around Photoshop and created a few photo composites just like these ones. My mind basically worked overtime just to come up with ideas. It was really fun. So when I started working with videos, I thought, why not do something similar? Why not try enhanced reality with video effects? And as one photographer once said, if you want reality, go take a bus. And I basically agreed to a certain extent with that. Of course, we want to be faithful to reality when it's needed, such as documentaries, but if you're into commercial photography, your main job is to help to sell the product or service. And among other things, you have to get public's attention, just like I mentioned before. Anyway, I've seen some effects done in After Effects and I wanted to try it out. I tried out the Replace with After Effects composition button in Premiere, opened the program, tried to move layers, and gave up. The interface seemed really confusing and it was nothing like Premiere's workflow. I did play around with some in-camera transitions or some match cuts, but these are pretty common and easy to do even in Premiere. I tried watching Video Copilot's tutorials, but these were way too advanced for me back then, although I do think that Andrew and his tutorials are among the very best. So I started looking for some basic effects. How to create a mask, then animate it, then transition between shots, so basically the most common wipe transition. Then I was trying harder and harder things. So first I came up with an idea, then I tried to find a way to basically make it into a reality, even if it means that I failed once in a while. It didn't really matter. A lot of my first effects were also hyperlapses, so the moving time lapses, if you didn't know. I preferred After Effects stabilization process, plus I learned how to properly use time remapping feature in After Effects. And this one is a little bit different from the Premiere's one. And here are some of the shots I did in one of the first commercial projects I did using VFX. To be honest, it's not that great. Some effects came out okay, but some not so much. But it's okay, I learned quite a lot and client was happy, the quality was just enough. And as you can see, there's a speed ramp, some tricky switcheroo, and I even did a screen replacement at some point. So if you're a beginner just starting out, don't give up. It's really easier than you think. I believe that anyone given enough time and given enough effort can learn After Effects to supplement their work. And trust me, once you learn it, you'll find a use for it every step of the way. So by this point, I kind of already knew the program, but I felt that in order to do what I want and whatever I come up with, I need to understand how it works and what actually can be done. Because I knew how to do some effects, I just didn't understand why certain effects were put there in that particular order. I bought a few courses, some straight up about filmmaking, quite a lot specifically about After Effects, and some about VFX in general. On courses alone, I spent easily upwards of $2,000. And to be honest, there wasn't one particular that I would say had everything I needed as far as After Effects goes. Meanwhile, I've had many inspirations and people I've looked up to. Obviously, Andrew Kramer being one of them, then later J.R. Ali's work and of course, Ben TK. The main lesson I've learned during the learning time is basically to come up with an effect, aim high and don't give up, even if it takes a few tries. You can fail, but so what? For a while, I kind of went on a tutorial spree, watching every single one that I could find, probably even too much instead of taking the time to practice actual effects. And I wish they were more to the point and explain why do we do it like this, not only what I should do. But I've learned a lot of different approaches and ultimately I do not regret it. All of this, of course, while joining Facebook filmmaking groups and groups that were only for people that purchased these courses I've mentioned. And I've met a lot of like-minded people there, which was very helpful in getting meaningful feedback and obviously words of encouragement, which is really important, especially in the beginning. How long did it take me to learn After Effects? Actually, I am still learning it every day. There's always a case I didn't see before and some problematic shot I have to come up with a creative solution for, but I think that's the most fun part, at least for me. I've seen literally hundreds of tutorials that would easily sum up to at least 100 of hours, if not more. So I guess my first contact with After Effects was back in 2016. So you can say it's been 4 years now. Not sure if that's a lot or not. I'll let you be the judge. I know there are people that have been using it since the early 90s. So the program has been around for a long time. How much did the learning cost? I'd guesstimate I've spent about $2,000 on online courses and I think it was well worth it. There have been, of course, courses that didn't live up to my expectations, but every single one of them had at least something to offer that I didn't see or know about before. My first videos, well, weren't great. But it didn't matter, I had fun doing them and that's why I kept going. Now they are looking a little better and all it took was persistence. And yeah, same thing with visual effects. Everything was really confusing at first, especially if you're watching two tutorials on the same thing, but they are giving you contradicting info, or at least you feel like they are. But after a while, it all falls into place. So yeah, you just have to keep going. A few words about courses and YouTube. Well, YouTube is notorious for that, but unfortunately some of the courses as well. Make sure you find a tutorial source that gets to the point and values your time as much as you do. Nobody wants their tutorials to be dry, but even worse is listening to life stories for 20 minutes when the effect itself could be explained and shown in 3. So yeah, all of the things I mentioned are exactly why I created my course, the Filmmaker's VFX Guide. I wanted people to save money and time, which is, again, more money. I believe that to show people basics and a few advanced but really useful concepts, you need a few hours tops. That doesn't mean you're master After Effects in just a few hours, don't get me wrong. But this means you can get through the course quickly, practice a lot, and get back to it at any point in time, whenever you feel like you need to refresh your memory. For now, the course has little under 8 hours, I think at this point. And for sure, it's plenty for you to get a hang of After Effects as a filmmaker. It's a step-by-step course for beginners, but also intermediate level creators. If you want to start your adventure with After Effects, check out the link I pasted below. And if not, thank you anyway for watching and hearing me out. And let me know what is your experience with After Effects, how did you try to learn it, and how it went. Meanwhile, hit me up with any questions you may have, and I'll see you in the next one.